Hey YouTube, it's Emmanuel from TechInsomnia, and today I'm going to break down the 2020 MacBook Pro M1 chip to see if this is still a viable, worthy option for purchase in 2023. Let's jump right in.
So the first thing we're going to do is a boot time test from power button to login screen. Very curious to see how quickly this computer can boot from a completely powered off state. 14 seconds. Decent, not crazy fast, but decent. How quickly can this computer sleep and recover from sleep state? 3 seconds.
So I'm recording this video using OBS Studio, and I'm using the built-in webcam and microphone. So can you guys see me clearly? It's kind of dim right now in my workshop, but I think it looks pretty good. Can you guys hear me okay? I'm using the built-in microphone on this computer to record this video. Let's check out the specs on this computer. Apple M1, 8 gigs of RAM. We're running the newest Ventura 13.5.1. Very strong and fast computer in my opinion. Let's open up Google Chrome. I've got my channel loaded here. Let's play one of the videos, see how quickly it plays.
Hey, it's Emmanuel from TechInsomnia, and today we'll be tackling a new PC build geared toward air for the least amount of noise.
We'll go on flush, so yeah, just a little trick. I've done it a few times, always turns out really, really well.
Basically, we're just testing the video quality right now to see how quick jumps to different parts of video playback. Just muted the sound temporarily. We're at 1080p right now. Let's jump up to 4K. Tiny bit of loading time there. But I mean, it's playing and jumping to other parts of the video pretty quickly. I mean, that wasn't super fast. Let's see here near the end. Yeah. Pretty strong. Definitely video playback on YouTube is going to be something that this computer does very, very well. Let's open up Google Chrome and do some searches. Just random searches. Let's go cooking. Nice. Let's go technology. Blazing fast. Let's go houses. Search is definitely very quick. Just for a little bit of contrast, let's open up Safari. And let's try Safari. Let's go google.com. Let's open up bestbuy.ca. That loaded up pretty quick. Let's check this out. Can't find your location. Projectors, I mean, pretty fast. Definitely, I mean, I don't see any hesitation or lag. Let's open up CanadaComputers.com. I mean, this just seems like it's literally blazing fast. Let's go Intel motherboards. Little bit slower to load on Canada Computers, but I mean, that could just be their server. Not 100% sure about this one. Okay. Let's open up some commonly used apps, just to see how quick apps open on this computer. Let's go Microsoft Word. That was fast. Let's try Excel. Little bit of hesitation for Excel, but I mean, once we're in it, the spreadsheet just opens quick. Let's try PowerPoint. Yeah, decent. Keep in mind, I'm running OBS Studio in the background, streaming the recording the screen, and using the camera plus microphone in the background at the same time, so everything opening and launching quickly while that's still going on in the background just shows how strong this computer is. That's Final Cut Pro. Let's open up Acrobat Pro. Boom, that just flew open. Let's open up Clean My Mac and let's run a scan. One thing I really like about this computer is it doesn't seem like there's any shortage of power. I was multitasking a couple different programs while I was setting this computer up, and I mean, blazing fast. Usually on other computers, I mean, Clean My Mac will, that entire process we just did, I think in a quarter of the time in comparison to other computers, so I mean, very fast. Let's open up Launchpad. See if there's any other programs here. Let's open up Firefox and do a quick little search. What can we open? Let's go staples.ca. And let's search for headphones. Pretty fast. The classic Sonys. I guess this is the new version of the classic Sonys. Yeah, so I mean, in a nutshell, this computer's pretty fast. I don't know how else to put it. All in all, I think that this is a very viable option for someone who's looking for a Mac that's powerful, but wants to avoid going into the actual Apple store and spending full pop on a brand new machine. These are ranging on Marketplace right now, at least here in Canada. I've seen them for $900. I've seen some for $1,200, $1,500. And that's in Canadian dollars, depending obviously on what the specs are. This thing is just incredible. I mean, we did all those tests and opened up all those apps, streamed videos, and the CPU is still at 48 Celsius with a 16% load right now currently. I was never really an Apple user or Apple enthusiast in the past, but lately they're making incredible computers and it's really hard to ignore the power of this machine. Hope you guys found value. Hit that like and subscribe button and stay tuned for more tech review, tech tutorial, tech tips videos to come in the future. Appreciate all the support. Stay safe out there, guys. I'll see you in the next one. Take care.